Dr. Kim Hammond from Falls Road Animal Hospital is here to answer your pet questions. Who did you bring? Who's your friend?
This is Cairo. This is a miniature pincher, and it's a blue miniature pincher. Look at the color of this thing.
It
almost has kind of like a kind of bluish tint.
Yeah, really.
You know,
there
are payoffs and problems associated with skin coats like this. The payoff is it's absolutely stunning. The problem is that a lot of these guys have bad skin. So you get a dog like this, you think it's going to be great, and they wind up losing their hair or getting all sorts of funny things.
Are there issues with dogs that size, health issues?
Yeah. I'll tell you the health issue I have in my household with a dog this size. It's called field goal kicking. They run under your foot, and you wind up kicking them three quarters across the room. And I do it accidentally. It's like, oh, Bubbles, I'm so sorry. Jeez.
They're resilient little fellows.
Yeah, no. You know, the problem is it's really interesting, too, and it's a good question because, you know, you take these dogs into your veterinarian to get them spayed or neutered. Mm-hmm. The amount of medicine for a dog this size is so minuscule that if you don't have someone who is really skilled in quality anesthesia, they can very easily overdose an animal.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Let's get to some questions. Mm-hmm. What causes focal seizures in cats, and what's the best treatment?
All right, so seizures. Let's just talk about seizures. There are a lot of causes of seizures that can be, and there are a plethora of reasons, some that are very complicated. For instance, there are things called shunts, where the veins in the arteries are actually communicating and you're getting poor blood supply. Mm-hmm. That can cause it. Tumors can cause it. It is very, very tough to deal with in cats. It's not a good sign if you have a seizure in cat. And the only thing you can really do is go to a neurologist, have them check it out carefully.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can a dog be diagnosed with ADHD? And can you recommend a treatment for it?
I'd have to say most of the time ADHD is bad training on our part.
Okay.
And so I would start with a good trainer like Mark Katz. You can get him. Mark Katz, by the way, is a great dog trainer. 539-3044. He's a great guy.
Yep, he's been on our show.
Yeah, he's a good guy.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Yeah, it's my
great
pleasure.
To see you as always.